Well, good morning. I'm your economics teacher, Priyanka Rai. I welcome you all on my YouTube channel, Economics at Your Home Student.
Last video, I discussed two properties of IC, that is indifference curve, that was IC slopes downward, and second, IC is convex to the origin. Now I will discuss about three more properties of IC, that is higher IC shows higher level of satisfaction, fourth, ICs do not touch or intersect each other, fifth, IC do not touch x-axis or y-axis. So let us understand these properties of IC. As discussed previously that IC slopes downward, it is due to monotonic preference. You all remember what is monotonic preference? So monotonic preference refers to more of goods always leads to higher satisfaction. I've taught you all that more of goods always lead to higher satisfaction. This is called monotonic preference. And monotonic preference is the reason that IC slopes downward. Now IC slopes downward from left to right. You can see in the diagram that it is slopes from left to right and it has negative slope. If someone asks what is the slope of IC, so you will answer that IC has negative slope. Why? You should know the reason also why. Because consumption of two goods is inversely related. As you all have studied, in order to consume more of goods X, we decline the consumption of more of goods Y. You can see here that to increase the consumption of apples, just see the diagram, to increase the consumption of apple from 1 to 3, the consumption of orange is declined from 5 to 3. So this is what called inverse relation between the two goods. That is why IC is negatively sloped. It is due to inverse relation. Since consumption of two goods is inversely related, so IC is negatively sloped. Now we will see slope of IC. Slope of IC is equal to delta Y upon delta X. What is delta Y? Delta Y refers to change in Y units of good upon change in X units of good. So delta Y, that is from 5 to 3, changes 2. Now delta X from 1 to 3, again 2. 2 cut 2 ones are 2. So you will get slope of IC is equal to 1. So this is how you can calculate slope of IC. Hope it is clear. If there is any query or inquiry, we'll discuss in our virtual class. So this was the first property of IC, that IC slopes downward. It is negatively sloped. It slopes from left to right downward, and slope of IC is delta Y upon delta X. IC is convex to the origin. Okay, IC is convex to the origin due to MRS. We have studied earlier also. What is MRS? Marginal rate of substitution. And marginal rate of substitution refers to the units of good consumers willing to sacrifice for consuming more of goods X, that we have seen right now also in IC slopes downward. Now what we will study here, that how to calculate MRS, or what is MRS? You all have studied delta Y upon delta X right now, that is the slope of IC. To calculate the slope, we use this formula. Now X 2 3 5 7, Y 6 4.5 3 2.5, so it is all marked here. It is all, it is negatively sloped, downward sloping from left to right. Now delta Y from 6 to 4.5, from 6 to 4.5, so changes delta Y is 1.5. from 2 to 3, change delta X is 1. So 1.5 upon 1 is equal to 1.5. like this we will find the MRS. Again from delta Y 4.5 to 3, how much change? 1.5. from 3 to 5, how much change? 2. Now 1.5 divided by 2 is equal to 0.75. so this is how MRS can be calculated by using this formula, delta Y upon delta X. Hope it is clear to you all what is delta Y and delta X, that is change in Y upon change in X. So this is clear. Now let us see the third property. That is higher IC shows higher level of satisfaction. You can see in a diagram, first diagram, I have mentioned here three IC, IC 1, IC 2, IC 3, students. Now let me tell you all that a set of ICs drawn in graph is called indifference map. When you can find more than one IC on a graph, that means it is indifference map. Now how higher IC shows higher level of satisfaction, you will understand from another diagram, where you can see OP is the amount of good which is constant at point S and T both. Now here you can see that on y-axis the amount of good is OP. Okay, now IC1, that is at OQ the point S is marked. Okay, and OR IC2 point is T. Now you will see this is higher IC. Higher IC shows higher level of satisfaction. That is what monotonic preference also we have studied. How? Because here OP is constant. It is neither increase nor decrease. It is constant for both. But here at OQ, okay, OQ, and from OQ we extend to OR. This we extended from OQ to OR. So here the amount of good X is increase, which implies higher IC. That means at point T there is higher IC, and IC2 shows higher level of satisfaction. So higher IC implies higher level of satisfaction. Good OR is higher than the amount of good OQ, you all know. From OR is higher than OQ. Okay, since it implies that OR is greater than OQ, so higher IC shows higher level of satisfaction. Hope this property is clear to you all. Now next property is ICs do not touch or intersect each other. Properties that we will discuss later in our next video. Students, go through this video, and if there is any query, we will be discussing it in a virtual class.